You may ask why I couldn't just rearrange or cancel the trip. Well, because of this, I put it like this. It's the same spark I got saying leave college that said sell your car, start fresh overseas. So at each pivot triggered this waterfall of blessings, man. And at this point, I got a fear of what would life be like if I don't answer that? I don't want to know.
Egypt has demanded change, and tonight, in front of the world, it got it. Once again, the politics of the country have shifted. For the second time in 2.5 years, the president has been overthrown.
Fireworks fill the air in Tahrir Square after news that Egyptian President Mohamed Morsi has been ousted.
Egypt borders Libya and Israel and is considered America's most important Arab ally, and now no one's even running it. It certainly is extraordinary to watch a moment of great celebration. The military has ousted the government.
So I touched down in Cairo, Egypt, at probably the worst time I could have touched down, or the best, depending on how you look at it, because I had the entire Giza Plateau all to myself, like it was zoned off for my shoot. That was some crazy shit, yo. But at the same time, there was protests in the streets and people getting gunned down, standing up for what they believe in. So that was something to see. Meanwhile, in the eye of the hurricane, there's Jimmy, the owner of Egyptian Night Hostel. He's 23 years young. That was his dream. He accomplished it. And he was very hospitable. So listen to his story. He could tell you much better than me.
The Canadian hostel, so we had to move all the stuff to another place. So I kept these things because they're older than me.
What happened with Canadian hostel?
The rent was so fucking high, man.
Where was it at?
The rent was really high.
And where was it located in the city?
I was just 3 minutes far from here.
No shit.
Right beside the Tahrir Square.
Ah, crazy. So now you're located where?
Yeah, now we're located in front of the Egyptian Museum.
Okay. And this is, what part of the city is this, Cairo?
That's Cairo downtown, Tahrir Square.
Okay.
That's just facing the Egyptian Museum.
Ah, cool, cool. Right by the Nile.
Yep.
Dope shit.
You can see the Nile out there.
Okay. And this is the former spot. Yeah. And you don't have this open anymore, right? This is closed down?
No.
Canadian hostel?
Yep.
I see. So what's your, how long have you been in this hostel?
In this hostel, only 2 months.
2 months?
Yeah, but I've been working as a tourist since like 7 or 7.5 years.
Okay.
I came out of my neighborhood, know nothing about the world. Since I was there, I thought the world is just the neighborhood. Staying there, chill out with my friends.
Okay.
But when I came out, I found a lot of different things, which I tried many times to introduce my friends about it.
Okay.
To take them out of their world and to tell them that the world is way bigger than what they live in. Some of them accepted, some of them thought that I just changed because of the position of business or stuff like that.
Okay.
And that's it. And I worked at the Canadian hostel as a ticket man at the beginning. I was like 16 and a half.
Gotcha.
And I worked for like a few months as a ticket man. I'd bring the ticket for the tourists, take them to the station, and then when I improved my English was sucks. When I improved it a little, I worked as a receptionist at the Canadian hostel, and that was for like a year and a half.
Gotcha.
And then after I was managing the Canadian hostel for like 2 or 3 years, and I moved out to another, a little bit bigger hostel.
Okay.
I ran it for like a year, and then I got back to the Canadian. I worked there for like 7 months. And then me and the owner of the Canadian hostel took this hostel as partnership together.
Ah, okay.
That was my dream since I worked in a tourist to have my own business.
Think about it. So Jimmy links me with Mohammed to get around and see the city. Roll with us to the last standing wonder of the ancient world.
Giza complex is a 12 kilometers square. It's a large desert. Because inside a lot of places highly recommended to visit.
Mm-hmm.
9 pyramids, three large, famous one, and six smaller, three for sons, three for queens. Inside also you can see Sphinx, the lion body with human head with woman hair. To be like a guard to keep the safety in the area. Inside also there is a mummification temple. Also the most important place inside is a little mountain or a hill. On the top of this mountain or a hill you can see the nine pyramids in one line, in one big shot.
Okay.
Because if you go far in the desert, you have a wide zoom.
Heaven's on its way. Heaven's on its way.
Hey, so y'all remember them horse lessons in episode one?
Oh, we gonna get you into some shit.
Right. And a ton of shit we got into. We stepped in all of it. However, it was for the cause, and it was all for this Egypt shoot. And 6 weeks, all I needed was the gallop. Because the idea came to me one night laying in bed after handing a couple rounds to the lady. You know what I mean? Got inspired. That's usually what happens. So I got up and wrote it down, and I got that vision very crystal clear of me galloping across the pyramid. So
before I could even crawl, bearable of the talents keep me charged up. Presence of death, even in God's touch. Dear Father, why does my crown got thorn studs? Blood dripping, constant blurred vision, rose tinted, see the world blossom. Only through pain do gain come in abundance. Candles illuminating, my prayers of love. Through my suffering, carry my custom fitted cross without tripping. I'm tripping.
So meet the crew. There's Willie Lump Lump, my man Wednesday, and Camel Toe up front running shit, of course. And let's not forget the horse named Tiger. Rightfully so, man. He was out for blood. Man. Whatever commands I thought I learned in Germany, them shits was not redeemable in Egypt. And blame this dude. Hamuda was responsible for pairing me up with Tiger the Henchman and the Humpback Trio. And no, he's not the police, alright? Shit. Cinematography by Mo, which is short for, come on, all together, Mohammed. Exactly. If you ever need some camera work there, Google Film Egypt, tell them Real sent you for the hookup. There's also Sharif the assistant. Salute. Yeah, and then the little homie Abu. He looked after the four-legged crew between shots. And finally, Hattie, Jimmy's good friend who came on a short notice. And you'll get to see all our talents in the upcoming Oasis video, inspired by Paulo Coelho's The Alchemist. And before I get up out of here, get Jimmy's contact info. In case you're heading that way, he's a great source to be in touch with. He knows not only his own city, like the back of his hand, but the country of Egypt as well, so you'll be in great hands.
Say someone's coming to Egypt, they want to visit Cairo.
I think they go on booking.com, search for Egyptian night hostel or any hostel world.
Okay. Booking. Yeah, I found you on Hostel World, and that was very helpful because you had a high ranking on there.
Yep. Thank you.
And hostelworld.com, and then you can even drop your number too if people want to call you.
Sure, if you want me to say it.
Bus it.
Yeah, it's 002-012-249-51105.
All right, and in Arabic too.
Okay, Sef Sef Itnain, Sef Wahed Itnain Itnain, Abba Tisa, Khamsa Wahed Wahed, Sef Khamsa.
Say what, man? I'm sorry, I'm fucking with you, man. All right, so it's the spot, and if you really want to know, if you're coming through, this is my room right here. I had room 505, and personal balcony. I had the great view of the museum, and I could see the river too, and the Ramses Hilton Hotel, which I thought was dope. So, and so on, man. This is Egyptian Museum. We're here with my man Jimmy, and your real name, your Arabic name.
My real name is Mohammed Jamal. That's why actually my Egyptian friends call me Jimmy.
Dope. Alright, brother. Well, it's been a pleasure staying here, man. Thank you.
It's been a pleasure meeting you.
I had a great stay out here, brother.
And I'm impressed about your project. I hope you do great with your project.
Thank you.
You rock, buddy.
Peace. It's Reallionaire Jream. Thanks for watching World Class Episode 2.
On behalf of the Jukebox Group, we thank you. This is Postcards. This is my latest project. We filmed for Oasis. It was completely insane. Like, everyone's walking around with these huge guns, fully loaded magazines. Here I am, bearded with a camera, you know. Fully loaded memory card. This whole story was inspired by Paulo Coelho's The Alchemist, a worldwide classic. If you haven't read that, you should definitely hop on that immediately. What I've done is based this project on the Las Vegas Strip. I grew up there on and off as a child, and all of the monuments along the Strip are from all around the world. Eiffel Tower, Paris Casino, there's Luxor for Cairo, Caesar's Palace for Rome. And each time I went into these places, I would imagine myself being inside of the city and feeling it out, because I always had a desire to travel the world and check things out. So this is that project. This is the one, man. Postcards, rightfully named. You can check it out at rdreamworld.com. That's www.rjream.world.com. Be sure to subscribe to our news. It's at the bottom of the screen. You'll find it. Just plug your email, you get money. Also, I want to give a good shout out to my good brother DJ SoHype at Hype World Magazine for the real estate. Definitely peace to you, brother, and the staff over there. Speaking of shout outs, there's brother Kamal Ali and the staff over at Pyramid View Inn Hostel. Yo, rightfully named. You can see the pyramids directly out of your window. It's unreal. I actually wrote the intro to the project right with that view. And you'll catch a bar in there if you check it out, when you check it out. And on a serious tip, may peace be upon Mother Egypt. With love, from the Jukebox Group, I'm Reallionaire Jream. Peace.